Hey, it's me again. I think I might be able to get myself to do another round of domain transitions right now. So where were we? We were clean, weren't we? Yeah, we finished clean. So it's 14:45. Let's log in. Oops. 14:45. Made myself a cup of coffee. So with a little luck, I'm going to 40:45, 14:40, 54. Sorry, 54 it was. So we got some new ABC denials. Let's have a look. What we have? We have deconf service coming up next. Deconf. Then we have actually a library that needs to be relabeled later on. Mislabeled library. So you can even find bugs if you look right. So deconf is run by dbus. Let's do that. Let's just do it. Paste that in. And just call that deconf. Deconf. Yep. This is executed by dbus, so we need to find a started domain and then just copy that over. Policy's getting bigger and bigger. Let's start by dbus. IAM settings daemon is started by dbus. But let's see. Damn. This one. Add speed to at spy. So deconf. Deconf. And then just, you know the deal. So I'm gonna try not to say deconf all the time. I'll try to stay quiet and just do my job. You know it by anyways now, so. Just look and see what's happening. It's I've been doing it like 20 times already now. So by now you should have an idea of what's going on here. Basically, these rules are just basically kind of like a template with rules needed for a process to transition. Basically, the macro would be the DOM trans pattern and some additional rules. And the deconf service is started by dbus. That's why I chose this set of rules, because this set of rules applies to the service that's started by dbus. So done. Make. Install. And then restore conf. Yep. Don't forget to restore the context, because else it's not right. we're done there. I just took a sip of my coffee. Let's have a look at the interface file. Where is that deconfigured executable file located? There. And then restore con v paste. It's restored. Let's log out. Let's sign out. And then let's just kill. And let's just check out ABC denials. See if 4059. See if XDM actually runs deconf as well. And actually it does. Oh, there's G shell and deconf. Yeah. So audit to allow recurse. And then send that to my XDM type enforcement file. And then after that, first have to run this. Quit. Now make and install again. This is not good for my SSH disk, my SSD disk. But I'm a dedicated guy, so I'll just accept that stuff. So what we have now is 1501. Let's see what we have. Should be clean. Are we clear? Yep, we're clear. So let's log in again, see where it takes us this time. And we're not even done by a long shot. We're barely scratching the surface here. Really. Really, 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 really. I'm not lying. These are the grep tools. We should keep them BinT, bash BinT. And we have here DNSSEC trigger, which is started by gsession. GNOME session. So copy that over. The panel. So these panel apps are usually started by GNOME session. I think that's one of the. Oh, actually, let's have a look. Because that might already be labeled, or isn't it? Let's see where. Yeah, it's BinT. No, it's not labeled. So we're going to label it. And I'll just call it DNSSECMOM. DNSSECMOM. And it started by gsession. So we need to figure out, find a session again, DNS of GNOME session started. Thing, and this one, GNOME shell, is also started by GNOME session, so we can use that. So let's copy and just get on with it. Copy and get on. And this only applies if you have DNSSEC monitor installed, but I have it installed on my system. So that's the thing. If you have other stuff installed that I don't have installed, then this stuff will break down terribly. Because because it will be confined and everything that's not taken care of will be denied. So, but it shouldn't be fatal. It shouldn't be horribly fatal. Of course, you won't be able to actually run that application, or you might. Nah, you won't. You won't. I'll be honest with you. You won't. You won't be able to run any. Most of the stuff you won't be able to run if it's not confined. That's the idea. Install it. So that's the main idea. And then just restore the context of the file, and also just check out, because I'm starting to doubt already. This went a little bit too fast. Did I do the transition right? Yeah, I actually did. Oops. No, don't save. FC, restore the context of the panel. I shouldn't have called it mom, but oh well. All right, now you know the deal. Log off. Out. Sign out. Get yourself. Kill. First kill, and then get yourself your AFC denials. And the AFC denial should be like 15.5, around about. But I don't think XDM runs DNSSEC, so that's fine. Okay, so then we can basically just go ahead and get on to with the next. Let's see what we have, and let's just also just have to take a look at where we stand. PS aux grab my login user. Take a sip of my coffee in the meanwhile. So we have DNSSEC mon, and now we have network manager applet coming up, abort coming up, tracker miner fs, data dub we already did, SE applet, tracker store, evolution alarm notify, dconf. Damn. I thought dconf was no longer used. But since it is, let's have a look at the AVC now. What's coming up? These are the grabs, the TR. Bash network manager applet, which is started by GNOME session as well. Okay, yeah, all these applets are started by GNOME session though. No, I'll just do this. Normally I use the space. Actually I should just use the space. NM app, Apple network manager applet, save and exit, type enforcement file, go all the way down and then make a comment, network manager applet paste. Now it's also started by GNOME session, so we can use this stuff, copy that, paste that in, and then just use NM applet and replace. You know the deal. some point we should be able to clean this up. Because it's more efficient if you group things with SE Linux. It's just more efficient. Save exit, make install. And I'm pretty sure that XDM also needs to run the network manager applet, I think, because if you're looking at the GDM screen, then you also see yourself a network icon. So probably runs it as well, but can't be sure. We'll see. Let's log out. And let's just do the things that we always do, like kill, and then like I'll search for 5010 and see if XDM runs. Seems XDM doesn't run it. That's odd. Then how come there's this? Oh, there is no network icon, actually. There is no network icon, actually. I thought there was a network icon on the screen. So what do we have? Abort applet. Also started by gsession. All these applets are started by this. So really, you should be templating this stuff. Really, 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 really. So it's ABRT apple. Copy, save and exit. Go to your type enforcement file all the way below and just append without the stupid thing. And we can use this one because it's also started. Oh no, this one. Whoops, here's something that we did wrong. Jesus Christ. Good thing I look at this, because we made a mistake. So they'll be cleaning up stuff. We made mistakes. I thought, somehow, unconsciously, I thought this is going way too fast. I must be doing something wrong. And it actually turns out it does. Christ's sake. So then the same here. Went way too fast, boys. Start making errors. good thing I'm basically using all their stuff so that I can basically eventually see where I went wrong. NM app. Okay, now I can basically use this half here. Jesus. I was thinking there must be something wrong. It's because it's way too fast. It's going way too smooth. And you know, routine is the worst enemy of a policy writer. Especially, you can see this here. It's basically routine job, these transitions, just doing it over and over and over again. And that, then all at some point you basically stop thinking and just doing, and that's when you start making stupid mistakes. And wasting valuable time. So although it's all very boring, there are some important lessons to be learned from this series of videos. Although the lessons aren't as expected as you may have thought they would. So let's look at this session. We have this session. Here's this cell. That's right. That's right. That's right. Deconf is started by Bieber, so that's huge. Okay. Yeah. This seems okay. This one here. Damn. This is what you get for routine. You make mistakes. You make stupid mistakes. But eventually you'll also fix them, because that's the nice thing. With SELinux you need to implicitly allow everything, so you'll eventually, if you haven't allowed something, then you'll eventually stumble upon it anyways. Restore conf, and then just a waste of time, that's all it is, but you will fix it sooner or later. Most of it. Okay, let's log out. And let's kill. And then let's just see what if XDM once has some business. No, XDM doesn't have any business with abort applets, at least not at this point. So let's just do it all over again. Man. Excuse my cough. Excuse my cough once again. That's the weather and the coffee and my ugly smoking habit. Tracker minor effects. And this is run by Sishin as well. Just do it. G minor FS. Try not to make stupid mistakes. Keep you cool. Stay sharp. Keep it accurate. Don't rush. Try to enjoy it, although this is hardly enjoyable work currently. But just think that it's needed. You just need to do the stupid work first before you can start doing the nice work. So just think about that, and then that should ease the pain a little. Getting windy here. We have good weather here in Holland. The sun is shining, but it's windy. But it's nice. I don't like that hot weather where there's no wind and where there's no clouds. So we have a little bit of clouds currently, but the sun is still on top of things, and the temperature is nice. It's comfortable. Let's see if XDM craps out this time. Nope, not this time. Then maybe next time. Kill. It's 23, so let's make that 22, see if the XEM runs tracker minor FS, and it doesn't. So we can basically just move ahead. We don't need to see that stuff. And now we all have a rather large list again. I am setting switch, which is run by GNOME session. Need to work. So we have imset D, then this will be imset S. Imset S. Imset. Go all the way below. Getting larger and larger. And then use this. And then just do the routine that we shouldn't do routinely, because then we'll make mistakes. Stay sharp, focused, think about each thing you do, because else it's gonna be a waste of time, and that's not nice if you're, especially with this stupid work. You're wasting time, you have to do it all over again because you just didn't think. And if you're not careful, it will happen. Don't have to be an Einstein to see that. Okay, almost done. All right, save, exit, build, install. Restore the context. And go over this again. And this might actually, a GDM might actually run this. Not sure. Nah, probably not. No, probably not. None of these applets, probably. Not sure. Log out. And see if XDM this time craps out. I'm expecting it to crap out. Yeah, see? I was expecting it. So let's go to run level 3 and back to run level 5 to reboot this thing. This time. And let's do our thing again. You know, we're killing. And we're actually going to 26 to see what if XDM does the thing. No, XDM doesn't do a thing. So then we are basically getting back to the routine again. Logging in, and the disk is filling up with ABC denials. We have SE applet coming up, also a GNU session because it's an applet. All these applets are GNU setting session. Sorry. SE applet. SE apple. Yeah, it's boring, but gotta do it. That's the way I am. Mm-hmm. So all these modules in a single, all these domains in a single module. Saves us a lot of pain, but you'll end up with a huge module with all these domains. So it's not very maintainable, but the upside is that it's easier. And it's all about balancing act. And I'm going too fast again. I noticed that. I'm going too fast. Restore calm. Oops. No, don't save. We did restore. Yeah, actually we probably did because we didn't see any ABC now, so we should have done that. Log out, you know the deal. Logging out. Logging out. Oops. Oh, that coffee is good. Keeps me going. We're killing. And then we're checking out what's up at 30. I don't think XDM is running this. And it isn't. So we can move ahead. What do we have? Oh yeah, we have this mislabeled library coming up here, this one. So we need to take care of that. This should just be libd, and then we can just forget about that. So let's just fix that. Just on this system, but make a note. Well, let's actually just add that to the policy. Well, then we will need to require libd. And I'll just make a note about that. Actually, I don't need to make a note about it. I'll see that soon enough. System view. Object R, and then libd as 0, and let's just escape the period here, and then go to my type enforcement file, and then I don't actually need to require libd, we already have that required now. So that should take care of this one here, of this execute of this library which was mislabeled. Next, we have tracker store, which is actually executed by itself, running in the gsession domain. So that's probably eventually gsession. Yeah. So that's just gsession. Let's just work. And I'll call this TR store. like I said, some of these might not need to be confined, but I'll do that anyway because I just want to make sure that we do have everything that might need to be confined, and then later if turns out that we don't need it, then we can basically remove it. That's easier than the other way around, that you first don't confine it and later confine it. It's harder to do. Okay, so where were we? Restore contexts. And we know that tracker store wants to execute itself as well. So that's coming up. I'm not going to speculate, but I'm pretty sure that we'll see next that tracker store wants to execute itself. I don't know for what. Let's kill. Then let's just see at 3-6 what we have. Nothing. Then let's just go ahead and move along. Actually not. And now we're getting all that XDG stuff, which is actually executing. Oh, and I didn't restore con this stuff here. Let's restore con that, so that that's gone. Now we're getting a lot of other stuff. XCG updates. There's, and where is that? It's located here. So now we're getting a lot of other stuff. Here you see actually tracker store executing itself. So we need to take tracker store. Oh wait, deepest daemon running tracker store. Damn, this is a mess how this tracker store is done. Anyways, let's just not accession wants to run. XCG user, there's home there. So let's not get ahead of ourselves. We're getting the tendency to get ahead of ourselves. Hmm. creative name. Is it the Upder? Upder. And this is actually executed by the user, by X session in the user domain. So I need to go all the way up. Where stuff was actually executed by the user. So these are all these stupid apps, these one-shot apps, so to speak. Those aren't daemons. Just when you think you're close, a whole set of new stuff turns up. That's how it works. That's how it works. And we just need to be keep focusing. Don't rush, don't get ahead of ourselves, and just stay cool and do our thing. Step by step by step. But I'm about to take a break again, well, in 50 minutes, so we should be able to do one more. After 5 relogins, TDM crashes, 5 or 6. Let's kill. And let's just see for ABC denials. We're at 43, so we'll take 42 just to be sure. Nothing. And then basically it's just logging in again. Damn. That nasty cough. Let's just PS out, grab my login user, because we need to have some motivation here. So we have this tracker store here, tracker miner FS, then we got this stuff to go. So we're advancing, we are, slowly but surely, but now we're getting into some apps that you don't see in the list, so it's more than you would think. Actually, so let's quit out of this and just go get along with our job, do our job. So bash. And this is TTK, so it's basically the same. We But this one is actually ran by G-Session. Well, it's not the same. But we could basically make this the same type and then just allow... Let's just make that the same type. Because it's just the difference is GTK. So this make that the same and just allow G settings to execute that as well. So we're getting here G session, sorry. My login user G session T. And then I'll copy this over. Because we don't need to really create a new domain for this one. I think that's my gut feeling tells me that. Probably has the same properties, but this probably has some extra permissions for GTK or something. Take care of it. Restore on that path is oops as well. And then the same stuff. Whoa. That looks nasty. Kill. Then see if GDM has business at 47. GDM does not have business, so that means that we can go ahead. That means that we can go ahead. And here we have Dbus executing tracker store, so we can basically edit that. Yeah, and we can ignore the shell for boom session. Yeah, so tracker store, basically TR store needs to be executed by Dbus as well. So that's basically where's tracker store, somewhere here, TR store. So what we're gonna do is my login user Dbus DTT and then just close that and then just build on that. deal with also transitions. don't get. Yep. And that's it. Yeah. Don't need to restore on anything, and I'm pretty sure that DDM is not dealing with this. You'll always see that. Oh, this D cell. This is not. This is not DDM. But here we have D cell executing pulse audio. We need to take care of that. G shell is executing pulse audio. So let's just deal with that as well. G shell is executing pulse audio. Where are pulse audio? Everything is executing pulse audio. Everything is executing pulse audio. My login user G shell G. And it's, is it actually? Damn. We should not haste. And I'll just copy this over, but I need to be sharp. And not jump to conclusions. That's bad. Jumping to conclusions is a bad habit. Let's look again. See, I can't jump to conclusions here because it's threaded ML that's actually executing. But it's running in the GNU shell domain, but that doesn't mean shit. So just ignore this. Crap. So you don't, you basically have this tendency to jump to conclusions, and that's just not a good idea. It's just not a good idea. Need to stay focused. Here we have Canberra TTK play. Which is run by GNU session. You have this tendency to I'll just call it Canberra. It's executed by G session. So we need something. Get G session clean. This will be the last one. And then I'll take a break. And it's also a little bit addictive, this. You sure know you're getting closer and closer to at least having all these domain transitions, or not all, but the domain transitions to get started. So there's this drive that gets stronger and stronger. But you need to basically refrain. Restrain myself. And we could basically just make all this stuff in one domain rather than all these separate domains, and then just there are ways to optimize this, really. Basically create one big domain that's basically to get started. Well, one big GNOME domain where all these different GNOME components run in, rather than all these separate domains, just to make it basically make the footprint a little smaller. All right, so I'm gonna log out now. See if it's kill the first kill, and then see if there's any anything else with regard to shutting down. But that's 58. We need to take 57. Nope, none. So I'm going to take a break again.